Welcome back to Phoenix. Tonight's starting goaltenders are brought to you by Home Hardware. And for the Flames, it is once again Mika Kiprusoff. The 34-year-old has played more minutes and faced more shots than any goaltender in the NHL since 2005. And for the Phoenix Coyotes, Ilya Brizgalov set a franchise record with 8 shutouts a year ago. He allowed 3 goals on 40 shots in his last start against Detroit. Ray Ferraro, all this talk about the Flames struggling to score goals centers mostly on Jerome McGinley, but how about some of the others expected to score?
Well, when they acquired Jay Bouwmeester as a free agent, he had come off back-to-back double-digit goal seasons for the Florida Panthers. He's got 4 goals in 96 games as a Calgary Flame. He's got to get more involved in the rush.
Underway now as Ed Jovanovski sends it rink wide for Lee Stepniak. And through the middle he goes for Belanger. And that long shot from the off wing is handled easily off the stick of Wojtek Wolski. And now Belanger back with it. Eric Belanger signed as a free agent in the offseason. Back it goes to Adrian Acoin. And Belanger off to a hot start for the Coyotes. Centering pass. Wolski with a shot stopped by Kiprusoff. And the Flames regroup. Jackman trying to get it out. The Flames hemmed in here as Belanger knocked it down at the line, kept alive by Acoin, and finally knocked out by Corey Saric.
Wow, are the Flames lucky here. This first chance was cued wide of the open net on the rebound. Kiprusoff had no idea where the rebound was, and then he made a terrific save on Wolski.
Bouncy puck on the side of the goal. Brizgalov dropped his stick and a hard time corralling the bouncing puck.
The Flames have been off for a couple of days. It looks like they haven't got the right start to the game. Watch Kiprusoff. He loses the puck here. He doesn't know where it is, and it's cued just wide of the open net. And then off the good cycle, Wolski, good position in front. Poor coverage by the Flames. Too slow. Bouwmeester to Wolski, and Kiprusoff bails them out.
Derek Morris, the former Flame, through the middle, and Peter Peruka picks it up for Phoenix. Tanguay almost intercepted that pass. Now to the Calgary zone it goes for Robin Regier, partnered with Ian White. White led the league last year in games played in the regular season. 83, won over the maximum as he was traded from Toronto to Calgary. Radim Vrbata across the line for Peruka. Shovels it back in front. Kiprusoff steered that away. Last year, Vrbata led the Coyotes in goal scoring with 24. That was the lowest total to lead any team. The formula, Ray, that worked so well for Phoenix last year was keep it close in the first period and then win it late. And we'll take a look now at the keys to tonight's game, brought to you by Tim Hortons new breakfast wraps.
Well, we touched on Ginla, we touched on Bouwmeester. Bork has gone silent. They need more from their top end players if they're going to win. They've got to keep the pace of the game up. You can't be a sluggish team, the Calgary Flames. And the Coyotes are a team, as you mentioned, Gord, that they struggle to score. They need a 4-man attack. Their D get up in the play.
Centering pass, Brizgalov down. Second try for Hagman. He's turned away. David Moss once again providing presence in the crease. And Keith Yandle swings back to pick it up for the Coyotes. Long lead pass for Scotty Upshaw. Upshaw across the line, but that is offside. And Upshaw gives a couple of late bumps there to Moss. Scotty Upshaw was leading the Coyotes in goal scoring last January when he suffered a knee injury at the end of the season.
Here's this chance for the Flames. The Coyotes are stuck after an icing call. And again, poor coverage. We saw it at the other end where Bouwmeester was on the wrong side of Wolski. Look at the position of Keith Yandle. What's he going to do with Keith, with David Moss when he's on his backside? He's got to get around to the front of him. He doesn't. That allows Moss a couple of whacks at it. Brizgalov is able to turn aside.
We mentioned, Ray, that last year all 4 games were decided by 1 goal. Just 14 goals total were scored in the 4-game season series between the Flames and the Coyotes.
Now, this doesn't smell of 6-5, does it?
You wouldn't think. Jovanovski through the middle for Kyle Turris. And he goes for Upshaw. That's knocked away by White. And chipped ahead. Ole Jokinen moves in. He's got Glencross with him. The pass in behind Curtis Glencross. He couldn't corral it. And now it's gathered up at center ice by Saric. Back for Bouwmeester. 2 goals in his last 78 games. And now Bouwmeester knocks it down at center ice as both teams are changing. Matt Stajan entering the fourth line now for the Flames as Trent Sutter mixed things up at practice yesterday. And now Stajan lays it back for Sarge, a long shot. That's blocked and a race for it now. Taylor Pyatt in. In comes Pyatt. Shoots Kipris off the save. The rebound knocked wide by Korpikoski. Nikita Kiprusoff with some early magic for the Flames. Puck loose along the wall. Korpikoski tapped it back. And it's gathered up. Jared Stafford with a long shoot-in that's steered aside by Kiprusoff. Stafford called up yesterday from San Antonio of the American League. Oliver Ekman-Larsson, the outstanding young defenseman for the Coyotes, sent to the American League this morning.
No shortage of quality chances here early in the game. Corey Saritz's shot is blocked by Taylor Pyatt. They get into a foot race such as it is. Pyatt gets out in the clear. Kiprusoff makes the first save, and then the puck bounces off of Bouwmeester's feet coming back and bounces over top of the cage. But two excellent saves early, one on Volsky and the breakaway on Taylor Pyatt for Mika Kiprusoff.
Taylor Pyatt still looking for his first goal of the year in North America. Scored in the Coyotes' season opener over in Europe, but hasn't scored since.
He was one of those players, Gord, that had a surprisingly effective year last year. He had really struggled for a portion of the year and then got his game in order in November and really became a pretty solid contributor for the Coyotes.
Now Stepniak turns it over. Ginla's out there, along with Brendan Morrison and Alex Tanguay. So Morrison gets a chance to center this. He called the number one line for Calgary, but that gets Brent Sutter's blood boiling. As he points out, on some nights, their fourth line has been their best. Sammy Lepisto plays it ahead for Wojtek Volsky, who chips that ahead. Stempniak with it. That rolled off his stick. And Mark Giordano is back to pick it up. Shots are 5-4 Phoenix in a scoreless first period. Coyotes coming off a very impressive win on Wednesday night in Chicago. In fact, their last three games were against the last three Stanley Cup champions. Home to Pittsburgh, in Detroit, in Chicago.
Dave Tippett felt they played better in Detroit, the game that they lost in overtime, than they did in Chicago.
Took 4 out of 6 points.
It's a nice little stretch. I mean, you look at their record, 5-5-5. It couldn't be more middling. Yet they feel that they're starting to redefine some roles for their team.
Now Backlund turns it over, fired by Verbata, and Kiprusoff got just a piece of that. Martin Hanzel along the wall, goes back to Jovanovski, a long wrist shot, that goes wide, and Bouwmeester has it ahead for Hagman. That pass in behind him. Jovanovski, in his fifth year with the Coyotes, is it that long since he left for Vancouver? Up he goes for Korpikoski, and sweeping in is Pyatt, bumped there by Saric. Korpikoski. Now the pass back for a coin that was blocked by Glenn Cross, and Bouwmeester plays it ahead for Bort. Rene Bort feeds it back for Glenn Cross. Glenn Cross centers it. Giordano's shot deflected, and Brzgalov kicked out of one. Good pace here in the first period. Both these teams play again tomorrow night. Coyotes are home to St. Louis, so rare back-to-back home games. And for the Flames, it's off to San Jose tonight, one of the hardest back-to-backs in the league. San Jose has an airport curfew, so the Flames will have to fly to Oakland tonight and bus down to San Jose. They'll get to bed about 3 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, there's no way to make that trip quickly when you fly into San Jose, and you're going with a leg down to start when you get there.
There's a shot by Stafford, kicked out by Kiprusoff. Now back at the line, Lepisto. Back for Stafford. Looks for the middle. Turris' shot was deflected. And back it goes to Lepisto. To Turris. Winds and fires off a leg and wide. And the Flames are once again hemmed in as White goes off the glass and out. Pass knocked down. And played ahead quickly by Regier looking for Meyer. Stefan Meyer. Spun around in the corner. And it's dug out by Turris. Off the wall he goes for Stepniak, who chips it ahead for Volsky, but racing back with Saric. Now Stepniak comes up with the puck. Here's Lee Stepniak. Rolling puck, spins and shoots. That deflects wide. Back out in front. Stepniak shoots again. Loose puck in front. Great save by Kiprusoff. as he once again shuts the door.
He's got to get more involved in the rush. Mika Kiprusoff's been busy through the first 7.5 minutes, 7 shots, 7 saves. Has had to be sharp. The puck management of the Flames has been abysmal, and he's been tested right in front of his goal a number of times. He looks sharp. An early lucky break, Gord, maybe gives him the impetus to a nice night in goal, but he's been excellent so far.
Belanger wins that draw for Phoenix, and Wojtek Wolski sends it back in deep for him. Picked up by Stepniak. Back he goes to Jovanovski, along shot, tipped right on. Kiprusoff kicked that away as Belanger got the deflection, slow to get to his feet. And now a long shot by a coin is gloved by the Calgary netminder.
Belanger looks like he's twisted his ankle a little bit here because the puck did not hit him. This is a nice move by Jovanovski. Look at him change direction. Aginla's got to do a better job of getting in the shot lane. There you see the way that Belanger awkwardly fell. But Jovanovski made one step to his right and then moved the puck to his left and shot it through traffic. Aginla's got to get out, front that shot, and at least make an attempt to block it. It can't go through him so easily.
Hanzel steps in for the draw. Coyotes controlling off the faceoff, but then Hagman took the puck away from Radim Verbata. Now Moss in, shoots, and off the turnover, a quick chance for the Flames, turned away by Brizgalov.
David Moss, we mentioned, is back from shoulder surgery and really played his best game of his three in Colorado. He told me last week he feels much stronger, feels pretty quick on the ice, but needs to get some games underneath him. Well, in Colorado, he got to the front of the net. There he takes a turnover and gets a quick shot on goal, but it'll take some time to get your feet back under you when you miss a month.
Verbata centers it, just missed. Pruka, who's taken down. He thought there should have been a penalty. And now Stafford with a quick shot, stopped by Kiprusoff. By the way, the Coyotes did not have a power play opportunity in the game against Chicago on Wednesday night. Verbata chips that in deep. And back goes Steve Staios. Giordano. Bottled up by Verbata. And here's Moss. Shovels it back and ahead it goes. Michael Backlund had that roll off his stick. The Flames clean it up, and Giordano, as Calgary changes, pounds that in. Keith Yandel swings back. Long lead pass, just missed Korpakoski. And as Bouwmeester goes back, that'll be icing against Phoenix as the reigning NHL Coach of the Year, Dave Tippett, looks on for Phoenix. And his team last year had just about everything go their way, especially in overtime and shootouts. They combined 19-7.
The reputation of Tippett is a strong defensive coach. When he was the assistant coach in Los Angeles, his power play that he ran was among the league's best. I played with him at Hartford. Very, very detailed player. Very, very detailed coach.
Last year, Phoenix had the fourth best record in the NHL. Battle for the puck along the wall. Fiat with it. Fiat with a breakaway chance a moment ago. Has that bounce away. Glenn Cross looks for it. And now Sarich with a shot. Rebound. Luke, they score. Rene Bork gives Calgary the lead.
Outnumbered in front of the net are the Coyotes. Glenn Cross and Bork on the doorstep. Bork does the honors. But this play starts on the rim around the boards. Hyatt is not able to get the puck past Corey Sarich. That's a nice pinch by Sarich. And you see Rene Bork was the forward covering at the point. He doesn't linger way out at the top. He comes all the way to the front of the net. And there are he and Glenn Cross inside of the two defensemen. Morris and Jovanovski have poor positioning. It's an unimpeded shot from the point. The Glenn Cross tip, the Bork rebound, and it's 1-0 Calgary.
Starts have not been a problem for the Flames, Ray. That's their 39th goal of the year. 19 of them scored in the first period. The problem has been the second and third. And here's Tanguay with it. Alex Tanguay fires it back in. There's a Ginla. Leaves it there for Morrison, down to Tanguay. And again, left post up in front of the net. Bouwmeester with a puck at his feet. Long wrist shot, flutters harmlessly wide. And a coin with it for Phoenix. Glenn Cross and Sarich draw the assist at 9:24. Ray Whitney waits, walks, shoots. Shot was blocked neatly. Moved to the line, but there was a ton of traffic. in the Calgary crease as Upshaw went cartwheeling in. We'll get a stoppage in Phoenix with the Flames leading 1-0.
There's the goal scorer, Rennie Bork, and it's a perfect shift for Bork. Look, he's in good position, third guy high. He jumps into the cycle now. He keeps the play alive, beating Fiddler to the puck. Once he reverses the puck behind the net to Jokinen, his job is to get back, is to be the high guy. He knows he's got a pinch coming from Corey Sarich. He defends up high, allows Sarich to pinch, and then gets back to the front of the net. Yandel's not firm enough on Glencross. Morris is a step slow, and the perfect shift from Rennie Bork ends up with a goal, and the Flames lead 1-0.
You know, in gymnastics, you're supposed to cover the entire mat. I think he covered the entire offensive zone there.
It's almost remarkable to see how much you can skate in one 15-second period. Bork was all over the offensive zone, and he's rewarded with a rebound goal.
Rennie Bork has three game winners for the Flames this year. The rest of his teammates combined have three. Bouwmeester plays it back in deep. Here's Stage with a chance in front. He missed Jokinen, and now a long drive by Bouwmeester. That goes just wide. And Stajan back with it.
Gord, the last couple of shifts, look how aggressive the Flames are. There's Bouwmeester down on the pinch as well. They didn't even have an opportunity to be that aggressive early as Phoenix carried the early play.
9 minutes remaining in the opening period. Shots are 11-8 Coyotes. Jovanovski peels back and falls. Moss centers it. And knocked down by Belanger. Kicked ahead by Stempniak, but kept alive for the moment by Hagman. And now Ian White tees it up, and he just missed high. White back with it. And the Flames counterattack, but Belanger broke that up. Jovanovski high in the air, knocked down by Bork, who plays it across to Hagman. Back to Bork. The Flames are late in a change, so Bork buys some time. Back to Giordano. His shot through traffic, knocked away by Brizgalov. Not exactly textbook, but he did make the save. And back come the Flames. Jokinen centers it, swept away by Brizgalov, and Bork took some kind of slash to his hand, it appears. He's making his way off the ice.
No, you know what? He took the puck, Gord. It went up underneath. It's either puck or stick up underneath his visor. He's gone right to the far end of the Calgary Flames bench.
So Bork immediately dropped his glove and headed off. He's being attended to, and play continues. Verbata lays it down low. Here's Steos with it. Up for Glencross. Sidestep Hansel. And Giordano being pressured. Plays it down for Steos. And Glencross was bottled up by Pyatt. And now Giordano finally moves it out. Mark Giordano. High backhand goes in. And a coin. Give his man Tanguy a hard shove into the corner. Brendan Morrison down for Tanguy. Back in front for Morrison. That's broken up. And Korpikoski had his pocket picked by Glencross. Morrison sends it back. The shot by Bouwmeester kicked out. And away come the Coyotes three wide. Pyatt, look out. Sarich belted him right in front of you, Ray.
Yeah, I don't know who you were saying look out to, Pyatt or me.
You.
Oh, don't worry. I was hiding.
I forgot. I saw you play.
I didn't see you play.
Fiddler. Oh, I was good. Here's Pyatt with it. Taylor Pyatt batting down there with Ian White. 6.5 to go in a brisk opening period. Fiddler plays it back for Lepisto. And now Pyatt racing to it. A pile up in the corner. And a hand pass is finally called as play comes to a halt, and Rene Bork gets some attention again on the Calgary bench.
You can see where he was hit. Now Eric Belanger's back checking on him. The puck deflects off of Brizgalov's stick and goes up underneath the visor of Rene Bork. That play's very similar to the play he scored on where he was out high, gets to the front of the net. You see Bork was just making an indication to someone on the Flames bench with his hand. That was Brizgalov poking away the puck on that centering feed from the corner. It came up underneath the visor and got him up high.
Now Iginla with it. Centers it there for Stajan. So Stajan, Iginla and Jackman is the forward line for Calgary.
You mentioned the blender came out in Colorado. It's out early here.
Ginla peels back. Going back to last year, Ginla's got two goals in his last 25 games. For a man who has been money for 30 goal years, nine consecutive. Ginla belted down there by Upshaw, didn't like that much, and now they're jousting at center ice.
Scotty Upshaw drives people wild. That's a clean hit on Ginla. Ginla didn't like it, and now Moss is going after him as well.
The conversation continues. And we'll step away as Upshaw wisely steps away from Ginla. 1-0 Calgary leads. You're watching the NHL on TSN.
Scotty Upshaw on the left, Jerome Ginla on the right. They come together at center ice. This is a solid hit by Upshaw that Ginla didn't like. Dave Tippett was yelling at Marc Joinette after the whistle. How many cross checks you're going to give him? He gives him three or four. They end up in a scuffle. David Moss comes in and the faceoff comes outside the Flames blue line. Good hit by Upshaw.
Yeah, very clean hit.
Man, he's one of those players that drives the other team wild. When he's at the top of his game, Gord, it's not a comfortable night.
He's also one of those guys who can score to drive you wild, and that's a big difference, right?
Otherwise you're just a guy that runs around and never touches the puck. There's enough of those guys in the league. Upshaw can hurt you both with the way he plays away from the puck, and when he has it, he can finish.
Belanger sends that ahead. And now Volsky looking for it. Wojtek Volsky sent a message from his head coach in late October, a healthy scratch for back-to-back games.
Can't be any clearer than that. Keith Ballard's getting it for the Vancouver Canucks right now. When it's a healthy scratch, and it's the old line, we're making changes and you're it. It can't be much more clear than that.
Ben Cross tries to shovel that ahead, and now Morris plays it across to Yandle. That pass went off a leg, bounces right up front for Jokinen, and the Glenn Cross shoots, he missed wide. And Bork takes a whack at it. Now quickly moved ahead by the Coyotes. Pruka with Verbata. And Robin Verbata saw Robin Regier coming and just missed getting hit by the 5-15. Now a coin batting there with Bork. And it's fired down to the Flames zone as Saric picks it up. Bork tips that, but into the Coyotes bench, and we get a stoppage with 3:55 to go.
There's been no shortage of turnovers here in the first period. This is Keith Yandle. His pass misfires. Jokinen finds Glenn Cross. Glenn Cross has an underrated shot. He gets rid of the puck in a hurry. He can really shoot it there. He just misses the short side to the right of Ilya Grishkalov. Glenn Cross had a couple of goals in Calgary after missing one game, the game in Minnesota, with a minor knee tweak.
Long shot on the Brizgalov. Lepisto getting bumped there by Stage, and the puck comes loose to Meyer, but he was poke-checked, and it's moved out. Now a race for it. Bollmister and Upshaw. And Upshaw giving Bollmister the business. Now back at the line, it bounces over the stick of Lepisto. Another race for it as Stajan comes in, and Garrett Stafford hustled back. Stafford, an offensive defenseman, one of the top scoring D-men in the American League. Lays it off. And now Ray Whitney winds back. Meyer fills him in. Jackman works ahead. And Korpikoski steps into him. Coyotes complete the change. And Lepisto moves it ahead for Pyatt. Up he goes for Fiddler. Vern Fiddler's long shot is gloved by Kiprasov. Well, the NHL on TSN is back next Wednesday as the Canucks go to Pittsburgh to take on the Penguins. Live coverage at 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific. Canucks road trip off to a good start. Impressive win against Ottawa. Now Jovanovski with a drive. That bounces down loose in front. Fiddler can't find it. And Tanguay plays it out.
Ginla does a much better job getting in the shooting lane there. He deflects as he tries to block the Jovanovski shot, but he takes all the steam off it.
Here's Korpikoski. Banks it back for Jovanovski. Wheels it across. And a coin had that knocked down and played up by Tanguay. Looking ahead for Morrison with Ginla. Morrison drops. Ginla was tied up by a coin, then mishandles the puck and it leaves the zone. Now Ginla Bumping there with Fiddler. Another guy who can get under your skin. On the all-debate team, Ray, would Vern Fiddler not make it?
Oh, he's pretty solid. You would have a tough time with him, wouldn't you?
And Bowmister swings back, being harassed there by Stempniak. And Belanger has it. How about Stempniak after the deal last year from Toronto? 14 goals in 18 games with the Coyotes.
And then had to wait. Had to wait for a contract this summer. And some of it is, you know, can Lightning strike twice? Can it be that again?
He's been great here, too. 14 games in this building. He scored 11 times. Stempniak shovels that through the middle. It's broken up by Backlund. And Backlund has that taken away again by Volsky. Minute and a half to go in the first period. Rene Bork's goal, the only one of this first period so far. In 82 games last year, there were only 102 goals scored in the first period of Coyotes games. Now Glenn Cross drops it back. Off the post goes Jokinen. And that puck bounces all the way out the other side and into the crowd.
Jokinen makes a nice play. He waits with the puck. He doesn't panic with it. Gets it up over Brizgalov, but can't finish. Here's yet another turnover. This is Lepisto. And when Glenn Cross loses the puck, it goes right to Jokinen. Jokinen tries to go shelf on Brizgalov, clings it off the bar, and the puck stays inside the zone. One of the newer rules, when the puck hits the crossbar and goes clear out, the faceoff stays in zone as opposed to going outside the zone as it used to.
Final 60 seconds of the opening period. Rabada steps up. And now bumped out by Glenn Cross. Jovanovski takes his time going back, and that will be icing against the Flames, who will not be permitted to change. Rene Bork is back after being dinged up earlier. 27 goals in 73 games last year for Rene Bork, who has suffered a series of horrifying injuries in his National Hockey League career. Skate cuts, and broken bones, you name it.
Yeah, some odd injuries that have really hampered Rene Bork getting the consistency season to season that he seems to be right on the cusp of.
Off the draw, scooped up by White. And Bork has that pass go off a skate, and now Turris looking for it. Whitney there along with Turris, and Upshaw bumping there with Kiprusoff. That's drawing a crowd. And now the Flames counterattack. Jokinen across the line. Long shot, that goes high and wide. Glenn Cross tried to play that in front. Yandle gathers it up. And in the final second of the period, Whitney brings it across the line. Upshaw trying to find Whitney. And now Giordano back for it. Left it there for Morrison at the horn. Upshaw gets a shot away, but that is blocked. Bork with the only goal of the opening period. The Flames with a 1-0 lead. James, thank you. Ray, it's no secret Calgary's trying to find a way to manufacture offense, and one way to do it is to activate your defense, which Calgary has not done much until this year.
No, they're going to have to get more play from their defensemen in the offensive zone. That means that your forwards have to cover on the long pinches. But after the seven-minute mark, we saw the Flames get much more aggressive. Bowmeister gets down on the half wall. Regier reads the breakout. Stempniak pokes it by him, but because Regier's aggressive, they end up getting control of the puck. And here's the goal. It's Saric who beats Pyatt on the half wall. Saric had pinched well down below the faceoff dot. He comes back to position. His shot's deflected, and Rene Bork puts it behind Ilya Brizgalov for the game's only goal. A player like Jay Bowmeister has such great skating ability. You can't just defend if you're a defenseman anymore. You have to use that ability to help create offense. One of the ways is being aggressive on the half wall on the pinch. The Flames did it much better in the last 12 or 13 minutes of that period.
Jovanovski, who loves to jump in, fires it down. And Ian White goes back, turns it over to Volsky. His centering pass was knocked away on a good defensive play by Michael Backlund. Now Moss goes in on a coin and gives him a hard ride into the end board. Moss looking for it. Now Stempniak goes rink wide and plays it out. White fires it back in. Nifty move in the corner. Hagman tries to drop it back. Loose puck in front. And digging at that pile was Moss, but Ilya Brizgalov has it.
Gord, right off the top, you talked about Mika Kiprusoff's busyness in goal. Well, Ilya Brizgalov has had 12 starts this year. In six of them, he's been over 35 shots. He didn't play the other night in Chicago. They felt that was a good opportunity to get Sean Burke, the goalie coach, in. He worked with Brizgalov, kind of a tune-up day. Brizgalov had the day off in Chicago, and he'll play both tonight and tomorrow night against St. Louis.
And Jason LaBarber, the backup, turned in a great performance. Allowed one goal on 30 shots in that win over the Hawks. And Dave Tippett might have been playing the stat sheet. LaBarber 4-0 in his last four starts against Chicago. Hansel, who's lost his bonnet, plays that up for Verbata. Keith Yandel jumps in for Phoenix, plays that through the middle. It's broken up by Bork, and away come the Flames. Lead pass for Glenn Cross. Glenn Cross takes a swipe at that, knocked away by Brizgalov. Now Jokinen knocked into the end boards, and Fiddler has it up for Verbata. And Kiprusoff had to be careful with that, as he had Fiddler bearing in, and that draws a crowd as he gave a snow shower to the Calgary netminder.
When Verbata throws this puck in on goal, almost instantly as it leaves his stick, it gets up on edge, and it takes a funny right turn on Kiprusoff. So Kiprusoff's in position, but this thing turns way to his right. Then Steos, who has been in and out of the Flames lineup, has played the last couple of games, gets all tied up with Fiddler. No penalties will result.
I'll tell you what, when Phoenix does get a power play, it might forget how to do it.
None in Chicago, none so far tonight.
Here's a chance right in front. Korpakovsky stuff. Rebound, score! McCoin with a shot. Tipped in front, and the Coyotes have tied it.
Nothing Kiprusoff is going to do about this. He makes a brilliant save on the first chance. Pyatt beats Steos to the loose puck. Kiprusoff stops Korpakovsky with a left pad save. The rebound comes to O'Coin. O'Coin shot. Watch Vern Fiddler in the bottom of your screen. Here he comes. Whoops. He's 4 feet wide of the net. It hits the shaft of his stick. Deflects into the net. Vern Fiddler, who won the faceoff, got some help from Pyatt, goes to the front, is rewarded, and the game's tied at one.
Gets his first goal in his last 22 games.
And he's about 6 feet outside the scoring area. He's just standing there looking for a rebound. Doesn't even see the puck. O'Coin shot goes wide of the net and deflects off the shaft of Vern Fiddler's stick. And the Coyotes have tied the game. Watch where Fiddler is. He's looking for the rebound. He can't find the puck. Oh, it hits his hands and it goes in. Right between the hands of Vern Fiddler. As I mentioned, nothing Kiprusoff's going to do about that, and the Coyotes equal the score a minute and 35 in.
Just saw Jerome McGinley watching that on the scoreboard, probably thinking, why can't that happen for me? Now McGinley battling with Jovanovski. Back goes Korpakovsky with a shot that goes off the leg, and Tanguay with it. Alex Tanguay drops it back for Morrison. Back in front, the pass goes across. McGinley shoots, stopped by Brizgalov.
Pretty similar to the Phoenix goal. The puck ricocheting around, and Ginla's going to end up the beneficiary. Below the bottom of the circle, the faceoff dot, Ginla takes it on his backhand. Brizgalov makes a strong left-to-right push, smothers the shot. That's been Jerome Ginla's first opportunity to score here this evening.
15-12, the shot's in favor of Phoenix. Stage it. Digging along the wall. Now Meyer looking for it. Stefan Meyer out for Stajan. And Stajan fights off Lepisto. Meyer takes a whack at that at the side of the goal, and back it goes to Stajan. For Meyer. Looks in front. Bullmister with a shot. He whistled that wide. And Saric plays it back down to Stajan. Stajan's got one goal in his last 30 games back to last year. So a number of these Flames in deep, deep goal-scoring droughts. Bullmister bumped there by Upshaw. Jackman came to fill him in. And Saric cleared that away. Now Yandle, long lead pass for Whitney. Up ahead for Stepniak, and Bouwmeester swept that away.
Good gap by Bouwmeester. He got up nice and tight on Stepniak, who had no room to make a play.
Saric up through the middle for Stajan. Calgary's changing. Stajan is shot for Zgalov to save. The rebound dropped down. It was cleared away by a coin. Now Regier with a shot that goes off a leg and wide. And Volsky with it. Wojtek Volsky fires that down. Kiprasov back to play it. 16 and a half to go in the second period. Another low scoring, close game between Calgary and Phoenix. Lead pass for Moss. In comes David Moss. Shoot, stopped by Brizgalov. And a good chance for the Flames. And Stepniak with it. Bounces that up to center ice as Steos picks it up. Steos up for Bork. And Jovanovski leaves it there. Stafford up ahead for Verbata. Looking for Hanzel. Prouk is alone in front. Hanzel can't find him. That pass was knocked away neatly by Steos. And away comes Glenn Cross. Drops for Bork. A shot goes off a leg and wide. Bork again hammered that high as Brizgalov was off balance. And the puck goes out of play. Tonight's Rangers Edge brought to you by Chevrolet.
David Moss gets an opportunity on the long lead pass from Robin Regier. It gets over Jovanovski's stick. Good shot by Moss. Brizgalov makes a nice blocker save to keep the game knotted at one.
Ilya Brizgalov, never dull in goal or before and after games. Telling us this morning that for 4 years he thought his teammate Tyson Nash was Rick Nash.
He should have been able to put that together after a while. No disrespect to Tyson, who does the color here in Phoenix, but you would think he'd have a better book on Rick Nash than it was Tyson Nash.
Speaking of books, he was once caught reading one on the bench in Cincinnati while backing up. He was reading Tolstoy on the bench.
I can't even imagine how that conversation went.
He does give goaltenders a bad name. But his coach, Dave Tippett, says he gives us a chance to win every single night.
Pretty nice waiver pickup for the Phoenix Coyotes.
Now a coin. Plays it in deep. Centering pass right on Kiprasov. Great save on Rolski. Puck still loose and Bouwmeester fishes it out. And away come the Flames. Tange to Iginla. Jerome Iginla centers at the pass. Too far for Bouwmeester.
Oh, I like that Bouwmeester's up in the play, though, Gord. It's got to happen.
Now 2-on-1 for the Coyotes. Volsky in, feeds it in front, score! Lee Stepniak!
Just as I say, I like Bouwmeester up in the play. The problem is, when Bouwmeester jumps into the play, and this puck is defended, Brendan Morrison gets caught chasing the puck. That's fine, but Bouwmeester has to pull himself out of the rush. He stopped at the blue line for just a moment. That moment allows the two-on-one to develop, and Bouwmeester's not able to get back. The other night in Chicago, Volsky on a two-on-one played a beauty for Kyle Turris to tip into the empty net. Today it's Lee Stepniak, and Stepniak gives the Coyotes a 2-1 lead.
Here they come again. Whitney in with a drive. Goes off the stick of Regier and wide. This is Stepniak's 15th home game as a member of the Coyotes. His 12th goal in those 15 games. Now a chance for Hagman, stopped by Brizgalov. And the Coyotes have their first lead. White with a shot. That's tipped right on. Brizgalov makes the save, and Whitney has it. Hacks it down as Phoenix changes. Stepniak from Volsky and Yandle at 5:22 to give the Coyotes the lead. Regier up ahead for Moss. Poke check by Jovanovski. And Pruka fires it back down. Now a turnover by Jokinen. Hansel back for a coin. Winds and fires a bullet. That is stopped by Kiprasov.
Jay Bouwmeester gets up into the rush. However, a bad read allows the two-on-one to develop, and Stempniak puts it away. There's Bouwmeester in the middle of the ice. He's still in fine position, except he doesn't read that Stempniak's gone behind him. He stops at the blue line. Once he turns around, Bouwmeester's got to back out of the zone and read the scene. He makes a bad read. It allows the two-on-one to develop. No mistake, Volsky to Stempniak, and the Coyotes two goals here in the second period, and they lead 2-1.
Derek Morris plays that down for Fiddler, who is knocked off stride. And Regier sends it ahead for Bork. Rene Bork, rolling puck, goes to Jokinen, his shot, he whistled that wide. And back it goes to Regier. Bork. Kicks that ahead for Glenn Cross. And now Jokinen gives Fiddler a hard ride to the boards. Yandel. Bounces that out to Pyatt. And Taylor Pyatt taken down as Fiddler plays it ahead. Still waiting for our first power play of this game. And the Coyotes are waiting for the first power play in nearly a week.
That just seems unfathomable.
Picked up by Jackman. Jokinen rather back for Giordano. A shot, pinball just wide. Now Jackman on Yandel. Calgary in the midst of a change as Belanger plays that ahead to Volsky. Wojtek Volsky works it across for Stempniak. Couldn't handle that pass. And now he muscles Stajan off the puck. Jackman tripped down there by Volsky, who gets the puck back. A lot of Flames fans here didn't like that non-call.
Gord, one thing that the Flames cannot do is lose any of their energy. You mentioned early in the game that they've scored over half of their goals in the first period. They've done it again tonight. A goal early in the first period that gave them the lead, and they've given up two here in the second.
Flames have only scored 20 goals after the first intermission. In comes Stajan, plays it across. It bounces off Tanguay's stick. Quick up for Upshaw. Scotty Upshaw, fire, scores!
In the pregame show, we talked about creating offense for the Coyotes, and three players have to be involved more, and Scotty Upshaw was one of them. This is a rocket over top of Mika Kiprasov. Kiprasov is a couple feet outside the blue paint, but this thing beats him up over the left shoulder. Turnover high in the offensive zone. It's one quick pass. Ray Whitney's got his head up. Beautiful feed to Scotty Upshaw, and the two of them, who have struggled a little bit early in the year offensively, combined for a goal, and the Coyotes lead 3-1.
Scotty Upshaw had not scored in his last nine games, and of course we talked about the fact that he was having a breakout year last year, 18 goals in January when he got hurt.
Brent Sutter's really gone to the blender here. He's got Stephen Meyer on the ice with a Ginla and Brendan Morrison. Morrison's minus two tonight. He's lost all seven of his faceoffs so far, but they're looking for something to spark. Again, it seems to be an ongoing battle.
The next step is let the players call their own shifts. Now Lepisto with it. Sarich taken down, or as Scotty Bowman once said, Ray, any five dogs when he called the lights. His team came back to win that night, not surprisingly.
Any five dogs.
Any five dogs, yeah.
That really fills you with good feelings on the bench, doesn't it?
Bowman's back, and that'll be icing against the Coyotes.
We've talked a little bit about Scotty Upshaw tonight, how he drives people wild both with and without the puck. Here he is crashing into the net with Tanguay, a finish on Sarich. This solid one on a Ginla that led to a scuffle. Here he is again in front of Kiprasov. And then just moments ago, feed from Whitney, and he fires his fourth goal of the season up over Kiprusoff for a three-run Phoenix lead.
Ray, he may be annoying and a pest. He's the Dalai Lama compared to the guy he was traded for. He was acquired for Dan Carcillo in a trade between Philadelphia and Phoenix.
Yeah, that's a little different player, I would say. You know, Carcillo has got his style of play. He can be effective, but there's no way he's going to produce the offense that Scotty Upshaw, a former first-round pick from the Nashville Predators, can provide. And you mentioned it, Gord, earlier on. 18 goals last year before he tore his ACL, and he's just getting his legs back underneath him. There'll be some ups and downs until he gets the consistent stride back.
Ian White was belting in behind the Calgary goal. Now Backlund drops for Hagman. And the long drive handled by Brizgalov. 3-1, the Coyotes lead midway through the second. Back in Phoenix, where Ray Ferraro spoke with the Coyotes at Jovanovski a moment ago.
Eddie, you lost your regular partner, Zbynek McCulloch, over the summer. You've had many different partners. How difficult has it been for you to get adjusted to who you're playing with?
It's always tough. Like you said, he's been my partner for the better part of 4 years. And you know, we got to make do with what you have. I've been playing with Oki here the past few games, and we're a little bit older, but we still can get around you know, as best as we can.
Hey, thanks a lot, Eddie. Good luck, eh?
All right,
Oki being Adrian Acoin, his former teammate in Vancouver. Here's White, steps up and shoots, and Brizgalov got a piece of that and sent it high. Morris. Lost the puck as it's played down to Glenn Cross. Now scooped up by Bork. Wrap around, try Brizgalov down. Glenn Cross took two whacks at it, knocked the second one wide.
Brent Sutter's got his three most effective forwards from tonight together on a line here. Jokinen's in the middle of Bork and Glenn Cross, along with Moss. They've probably been the most noticeable of the Flames forwards.
Now Glenn Cross plays it down low. Jokinen a shot that got blocked by Morris. Giordano a drive that's kicked away by Brizgalov, and now Stales with it. Jokinen centers it. That's tapped away by Morris. And Yandle with time flips it out for Pyatt. As Giordano goes back. Lead pass for Jokinen as the Coyotes are changing. Jovanovski steps away from Jackman. And competing chants are going up here from the Calgary fans in attendance. As Aginla digs in the corner for it. Big sports weekend here in the Valley area. Cardinals play on the weekend, and there's a big NASCAR race as well. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is here tonight.
Now right across the street, the Seahawks will play Arizona on Sunday. Game for first place in that division.
Now Turris with a steal of Whitney. He's stopped by Kiprusoff. We'll gather up the rebound. So Ed Jovanovski's done a lot of good things in his career. Won an Olympic gold medal. How about scoring his first career hat trick against Nashville on November 3rd?
He couldn't have got much lower to the goal line on that one. And then on the back door, he puts it away. It's three goals for Jovanovski, who, as Dave Tippett was telling us before the game, they need offense from their back end, and Jovanovski gives it to him. He'll get up in the play. He's got to finish some for them.
Long drive by Lepisto goes wide. Jovanovski's unrestricted at the end of the year. He'll get some interest.
Well, he doesn't have a chance to talk to anybody here until this ownership is finally settled. Backlund. There's nobody to discuss it with.
Backlund's long drive is steered away. The potential new owner of the Coyotes was in Chicago watching the team play earlier this week and actually addressed the club and told them that when he gets control of it, that he looks to make the Coyotes a contender. So most goals by defensemen, Buffalo has the most, followed by Phoenix. And the Coyotes have been among the league leaders the last 4 or 5 years. Is Ed Jovanovski looking at that graphic?
Yeah, he is. He was watching, looking for the highlight. Then he saw the graphic popped up and he leaned over a little farther. I'll just turn it so they can see it better.
Belanger took down Glenn Cross. And so the Coyotes are going to be shorthanded for the first time since the second period against Detroit. And Calgary will get a power play chance here.
It's the cross check that gets called for Belanger as he shoves Glenn Cross in to the boards. The game's first penalty. 12 and a half minutes into the second period. Brent Sutter was telling us before the game that one thing that's helped this power play go a bit is a better net front presence. Glenn Cross and David Moss. Here goes Glenn Cross to the front of the net.
Calgary 2 for 26 on the road in the power play so far this year. White shoots, scores! 3 for 27.
Well, that didn't take very long.
Ian White with a blast from the point, his second goal of the year.
Jokinen wins the draw. Nice little give and go, Bork and White. Korpikoski gets out to block the shot, but because he doesn't block it, he just gets in the way. Not a good look for Brzgalov here. The Flames have traffic in front of the net. Ian White's shot beats Brzgalov up high over the glove, and the Flames are back in at 3-2.
Now Regier tries his luck. That goes wide. And Brzgalov steers that attempt away. Finally cleared to the line, but not out. Hagman with it. Nicholas Hagman plays it back in deep. Shots are even at 20 apiece. Coyotes lead 3-2. One thing Ian White has always been able to do, Ray, is really shoot the puck. And you wouldn't guess that to look at him. He's not exactly a physically imposing guy. But for whatever reason, he can really put some steam on it.
I guess it's like hitting a golf ball. You got the right technique, you got the right timing, you can shoot the puck. And he didn't waste much time getting rid of that, and his shot is perfect up over Brzgalov's shoulder.
8 seconds into that power play. White from Bork and Jokinen at 12:40. Now Stales fires it in. Jovanovski peels back. His clearing attempt almost bounced right in front. Now a coin is bottled up. And Jovanovski goes racing to it. Look out. He got thumped there by Jackman.
It's a crucial time in the game. You see how the energy's changed with the White power play goal. The Flames are on the puck. The Coyotes are a step slow.
McGinley back for Giordano. And his shot goes off a stick and out of play. The NHL on TSN. Back to the desert after this.
Here's the anatomy of a power play goal. Jokinen swipes the faceoff from Hanzel. Little give and go, Bork and White. So Korpikowski's got to defend the cross seam pass. That gives White 20 feet of room to tee it up. And look at this battle in front of the net. Brent Sutter was telling us about the traffic that Glenn Cross has provided. He and Jovanovski get into some combat in front of Ilya Brzgalov, who doesn't get a good look at it. 8 power play goals in 8 games for the Calgary Flames.
Here's Bork with a chance. He shoots, but Brzgalov knocks that down. By the way, the Flames have embraced Movember in a big way. Almost all the players growing mustaches. And in the second week of November, they're at that awkward stage where a number of them look like Bolivian postal clerks.
I can't say I know what postal clerk from Bolivia looks like.
A customs agent, you know, just one of those bad mustaches.
There's a couple guys that look like they've been working pretty hard at it, and it's really not coming in very well for them.
There's Brzgalov, knocked it down. Glenn Cross runner plays it back in front. And here's Stales playing it in deep. Knocked down by Jokinen. Jokinen feathers that in front, tapped wide by Bork, who looks skyward. Can't believe he missed. And Giordano steps up. Drops it back. Jokinen feeds it in front. Glenn Cross shoots. Oh, a glove save by Brzgalov. Takes it right away from Curtis Glenn Cross.
About 4 minutes ago, Brent Sutter put Jokinen with Glenn Cross and Bork, and they've had 2 excellent shifts together. They're on the ice for the power play goal. Here's Jokinen to Bork. He shoots this point-blank shot wide, and then Jokinen goes across the seam. Glenn Cross gets, that's a very good release. Brzgalov flashes the leather. And the Flames have taken some of the momentum here and turned it on the Coyotes late in the second period.
Cole Mister, long lead pass for Stajan. Stajan peels back. This is Stajan with Aginla and Jackman. Jackman feeds it in front, and Aginla deflected that off the post. So this is basically Aginla taking Meyer's place on Calgary's fourth line. Now a chance for Pyatt. He's stopped by Kiprusoff. Chance in front, and Pyatt couldn't quite get to it. And now Saric moves ahead, knocked off the puck by Fiddler. Aginla did spend some time on the bench in the Detroit game. So did Stajan. Both were under 14 minutes played in that game. Jackman to Stajan. Now shot hammered wide by Hagman. Calgary in the midst of a change as Kyle Turris brings it ahead. And White knocks that to the line and just out. Now a pass ahead for Hagman. Out there with Moss. And Backman. The pistol fell. Moss is all over him. And Backman digs for it. Battling there with Turris. Backman still with it. Pulls the puck out of the corner. Michael Backman shovels it back in deep, and the cycle is re-engaged. Here's Moss with it. 3:15 to go in the second period. Moss for Hagman. Back to Moss. A backhand shot, and Brizgalov is able to make the stop. Well, the million-dollar shootout is back. You can take to the ice at the World Junior in Buffalo live on TSN to try to win a Chevrolet Cruze. And $1 million. Visit tsn.ca/cruise for full details and how to enter. And Bobby Orr will be there.
Aginla's deflection goes off the goalpost. The closest he's come, he had a chance earlier that Brizgalov made a save. There's
Glenn Cross from his knee. Shoots! Brizgalov the save and a penalty coming up to the Coyotes. Tripping will be the call. It'll go against Yandel, and the Flames, who took just 8 seconds to score on their first power play, are back on the man advantage.
They can't get this Glenn Cross, Jokinen, and Bork line on the ice enough right now. Off the faceoff, Glenn Cross stronger on the puck than Keith Yandel. Yandel pulls his feet away. Glenn Cross still gets away. A dandy scoring chance, yet the Brizgalov's able to get the pad on. This line will stay on the ice with Bouwmeester and White, the same crew that scored a power play goal moments ago.
Fiddler wins the draw, a coin to the line, but not out. Jokinen tries to center it, now a coin falls, tries to throw the puck ahead. Jokinen to Bouwmeester, to White. Back to Bouwmeester, being harassed there by Fiddler. Bouwmeester pulls it in deep. Out the other side for Bork. Rene Bork feeds it in front for Bouwmeester, that skipped off his stick. Now Bork with it. Looking back for White, but that pass handcuffed him and came out. Jokinen jumps in across the line, drops it back for Bork, but again the pass misfires. And Calgary has to regroup. Rink-wide pass for White, who kicks that ahead. Back goes Jovanovski. With time, fires it out. Here's Hanzel shorthanded as Calgary is changing. Hanzel peels back. Hagman had lost his stick, and that allows Phoenix time to fire it down the ice. And Lepisto does just that. 50 seconds to go on the Calgary power play. Giordano fires it ahead. Now it's Moss with Aginla and Tanguay. Back at the line is Giordano. For Aginla. Aginla drops it back. Here's Hagman with a drive. He's stopped by Brizgalov, and the Coyotes are able to clear. And the puck was played with a high stick. We'll get a stoppage with 1:18 to go in the second. 20 seconds to go in the Calgary power play.
Nick Hagman is a player playing at the top of his game when he is shooting the puck. Here he takes a nice feed from Aginla. Hagman finds the soft spot on the ice. Pad saved by Brizgalov again through traffic. Both Glenn Cross and Moss have done a nice job on the power play, impeding the view of Ilya Brizgalov.
Face off in the Flame zone. Giordano being watched there by Hanzel. McGinley. Up he goes to Hagman. Now sent in front. Brzgalov bobbled that puck for a moment. Hagman gets into it now with Hanzel and Jovanovski, and a big crowd gathers behind the Phoenix goal.
Not the most certain of plays by Ilya Brzgalov. It looked like for a moment like he was going to come out and shoot the puck, which is never a good idea for him because it's an adventure when he does shoot it. So he comes out and freezes it, and then Hanzel, Hagman, and Jovanovski come together at the side of the net, creates a crowd, and the whistle. Just 3 seconds left in Keith Yandel's minor penalty.
Again, Len for the draw against Hanzel. And a scramble draw controlled by the Flames. Back to Bouwmeester as Yandel steps out. Giordano shot deflected down in front. And a quick drive there by Backlund is stopped by Brzgalov. And Ginlow bowls over Peruka. Peruka's lost his stick. And now just swipes at it and knocks the puck down the ice. Backlund chips that into the Phoenix zone as a coin is back to pick it up. Up he goes for Hanzel. And Regier swings back with 20 seconds to go in the period. Calgary led 1-0 after one. It's now 3-2 Coyotes. Jokinen deals it back. There's White with a shot. That's knocked down by Hanzel in front. Unsure of his stick for good reason. It broke because he tried to play the puck out. Now Bork with the puck. Bork centers it. And Jokinen took a whack at that as time expires. Coyotes up by one as we send you to James Duthie and our second intermission. Ray, in the new economics of the game, it can be hard for coaches to get into battles with players, but one thing coaches can control is ice time, and Brent Sutter the last couple of games has simply rewarded the players who are playing well.
There's really no other way to wheel the whip, and so after going away from this line for a little bit, Brent Sutter put Glenn Cross, Bork, and Jokinen back together. Glenn Cross had a couple of goals in Colorado. He's been all over the place, in particular in the last half of the second period. Here he out-muscles Yandel for a puck, draws a penalty. And on that penalty, he gets into a battle in front of the net with Ed Jovanovski. Brzgalov's looking for the puck. White scores, but it's all Glenn Cross in front of the net who creates the traffic, distracts Brzgalov, and Brent Sutter couldn't get that line on the ice enough late in the second period. And he'll start the third period with Jokinen, Bork, and Glenn Cross.
So they get the bump up, the bump down. Alex Tanguay, -3 in the game, has not had a shift since the third Coyotes goal.
It'll be interesting to see if he gets another crack or if Brent Sutter has just shut him down for the rest of the night.
Long drive as Kiprusoff knocks that up into the crowd. But it's very difficult, Ray, for coaches to get through to players sometimes. So short of benching them or scratching them from games, and we've seen that a number of times. We talked about the fact that Wojtek Volski was a healthy scratch for a couple of games.
When you sit a player out of the lineup, you know, much is made about how much money he makes. You know, Keith Ballard sitting in the press box making $4.2 million in Vancouver. They're already on the cap. They're already paying that money anyway. So the coach has to play the guys that give him the best chance to win. And at some point, the money does matter, but you've got to play your best lineup.
Back with a long shot. Well, coaches will always tell you, when they look down, they don't see salaries, they see numbers. And that's all they can worry about. Yandel turns that over. And now Moss digging for it. The chance at the side of the goal. Hagman turned away. Now Hagman gets it back, bumping there with Morris. And Morris shoves Backlund face first into the end boards. And the Flames are going back to the power play as Hagman is slow to get to his feet.
Derek Morris has a word for Hagman behind the net. Nice work by Hagman, keeping the cycle alive. Oof. I mean, that's an easy call to make. It's a penalty every time. Morris shoves him directly on the numbers into the boards. Hagman sells it a little bit as he goes to the ice. But man, that hurts. I mean, you fold it in half the wrong way. You see Hagman in some distress right to my left, and there you see Derek Morris across the ice. The Flames go back to the power play, and not surprisingly, Jokinen, Bork, and Glenn Cross hit the ice.
Off the draw, the puck control as Jokinen plays it back for White. Shoot! That hit something in front. Might have hit Glenn Cross in the back, and now Glenn Cross is going at it with Jovanovski, who's lost his stick. Another shot by Bullmister, that goes wide. Now Jovanovski retreats to get his stick and gets back into play.
Well, Glenn Cross is doing a heck of a job here in front of the net. He's in a battle now with a coin.
And Jovanovski gets to the puck and fires it down.
When you're in front of the net and you're in the battle with the defenseman, you can't forget that you're on the power play. You're not a fullback just blocking. You've got to have your stick on the ice at times to be in the play.
Here's Bork with it. Back for Bullmister. To White. Back to Bullmister. Now Bullmister plays it down. Jokinen. Back up the other side. Bork to White. Shoots, and a pad save by Brzgalov. Not sure he saw that, but somehow got the pad on it.
That's great puck movement by the Flames. It results in the White point shot again through much traffic in front of Brzgalov.
Calgary changing D on this power play, and Ginla jumps on as well. Yandle on the turnover just fires that down. Calgary in San Jose tomorrow, and still to come this month, a five-game Eastern road trip. A punishing month of November for the Flames in the midst of a stretch of 8 out of 10 on the road. Morrison drops it back. Giordano, a shot tipped wide by Ginla. Ginla knocked down in the corner. Puck comes up to Korpakoski. 15 seconds to go in the Phoenix penalty.
Korpakoski goes right across the ice. That's a forward over there. Heads up play by Korpakoski. Tries to challenge Morrison on the one-on-one.
Cajun steps around Hanzel, loses the puck, and Yandle fires it down as Morris steps out. 3-2, Coyotes lead. 3 minutes gone in the third period. Stajan up ahead for Jackman. And Jackman and the pistol collide. Now a centering pass, knocked away by Brzgalov, and Alex Tanguay's back on the ice. Knocks that puck away from Peruka. So his stay in the Chateau Bow Wow of Brent Sutter is a brief one. Second half of the second period. Rivano with a shot, stopped by Kiprasov.
Pretty sure Chip, though, he's sitting right beside me already.
One thing at a time.
Baby step, baby step.
Well, he wasn't on the ice for a goal against, which is a good start. He's been on for all three Coyotes goals tonight. Yandle with it. Yandle, lead pass for Upshaw. In comes Scotty Upshaw on Bullmister. Try a little dipsy doodle, and Bullmister knocks him down. Here's Yandle with it. Plays it across for Turris, who keeps the puck alive for the moment and looks in deep for Upshaw. Yandle with it. Phoenix still waiting for its first power play of this game. Did not have one against Chicago either. They haven't had one since Monday night against Detroit. Bullmister up for Jokinen. Ole Jokinen works his way in. Sends it back in front. The pass was in behind Glenn Cross. And now Turris gets spun around. Kyle Turris up ahead for Stempniak. Flames are changing as Stempniak brings it in. Stempniak shoots. That's deflected wide off the stick of Regier. And Regier hammered Stempniak down in the corner as the puck goes into the Calgary bench.
Here's a player just coming into his own as Keith Yandle. Man, can he skate. Watch him take off from behind the net. Gets away from the forechecker. Crisp pass up through the skates of Sarich to Scotty Upshaw. Well defended by Jay Bullmister. Yandle can move. He can really get up into play, and he's not shy. The other night in Chicago, he started a two-on-one by getting up into the play. Tonight, in one of the goals, he was He got the puck up to Volsky. Volsky finds Stempniak, but it's because of his skating ability he can get up on the play that quickly.
Here's White with a shot, tipped in front and knocked down to Morris. Yandle scored 12 goals last year for the Coyotes. Be a candidate for the all-underrated team. Volsky up ahead for Stempniak. Swings it across for Yandle, who had jumped in, then now chips it in deep and goes off on a chain. McGinley takes a whack at that, but the puck goes flying into the Phoenix bench. Play call with 5.5 to go, and Jerome McGinley, who has been very good in this building, 11 goals in 12 games in his career in this building. McGinley does not have a shot tonight. The last time he did not have a shot in a game, March 3rd of this year against Minnesota.
If he doesn't have a shot tonight, I don't know who's keeping track of it, because I remember one from below the left faceoff dot that Brzgalov made a nice push and smothered across.
Officially, he does not. can you appeal that?
Oh, I don't think he should, but no. It's pretty obvious that he... There is Ginlett to my left. I thought the back half of the second period, Gord, he's played his best hockey of the game. Ginlett's been far more energetic towards the tail end of that second period. He's got to skate. He's got to push his legs. He's got to create some separation from the players that are checking him. If not, he's never going to clear room to shoot the puck.
Saric hammering down Peruka, who's back in the play. And now Tanguy steps up. And Alex Tanguy comes flying in. Look out, was wheeling in on Lepisto and just missed him. Now tip right on Brzgalov, the save, loose in front. Meyer takes a whack at that. Tanguy couldn't get a chance to pull the trigger on the rebound. And now Hanzel backhands that to the line and not out. Now Hanzel back with it. 3-on-2 for Phoenix. Hanzel drops it off for Verbata. Centering pass bouncing in the air, and Kiprusoff takes that away from Peruka. The NHL on TSN is back to the desert in a moment. Monday night was a history-making evening at the Hockey Hall of Fame, and among those inducted, the great Cammy Granato, who was, of course, an Olympic gold medalist with Team USA at the 1998 Olympic Winter Games. She, along with Angela James, the first two women to be inducted into the Hall of Fame, and among those in attendance, her family, including her husband, Ray, her children, Riley and Reese. Ah, there you go. Yeah. How good was that, huh?
It was a great night. Little Riley was on my lap. He was waving to his mom halfway through the speech. He was starting to climb up on stage. I'm like, oh, no, if he gets up there, this is going to be a disaster. Very, very proud of her. It was just a wonderful night.
Well, there's a power play coming for Calgary. Scotty Upshaw's going off. Dave Tippett was pleading his case during the commercial break that Phoenix has not had a power play in the last couple of games. Well, guess what? It didn't work. Upshaw goes off, and Calgary's back on the man advantage.
Much like the last penalty that Derek Morris took, there's no complaint here to make if you're Phoenix. Upshaw gets a stick in the feet of Robin Regier. They go back to the power play. Calgary's made one change here on this power play. Mark Giordano's replaced Bouwmeester on the left point. The other four players remain the same.
Giordano steps up, knocked by him. And away comes Fiddler. Vern Fiddler centers, and Korpikoski tapped that wide. A great shorthanded chance for the Coyote. Olli Jokinen across the line. Korpikoski gets a stick on him. Now Bork with it. Down for Jokinen. Plays it there for Giordano. Bork feeds it down to Jokinen. Glenn Cross battling for space in front. There's a shot by Giordano that's knocked away neatly by a coin and fed down the ice by Fiddler.
That's a nice read by a coin. Once the shot comes, he steps in front of Giordano and fronts it, clears the puck down the ice.
Now Bork moves in. Rene Bork, rink wide pass for White. His wrist shot is blocked by Pyatt. But Bork kept the puck alive for Giordano. In deep for Glenn Cross. For Jokinen. Back to White, waiting for the traffic to establish in front. Jokinen deals away from Hanzel, but Hanzel got a stick on that. Now a race for it. And an exhausted Hanzel elects to peel off on a chain.
Yeah, that wasn't going to be much of a foot race. Hanzel and White were both totally gassed. White retrieved the puck and just left it for Morrison. He'll get off the ice.
Morrison. Crossy goes to McGinley. Steps around Fittler. The centering pass is knocked down. And Fittler plays it out. And Alex Tanguy out there on this Calgary power play. Works it in deep. Looking there for Bouwmeester. Now a broken stick. Jovanovski, some nervous moments as he runs back to the bench and grabs another. Morrison up through the middle for Hagman. That's knocked down and cleared out neatly by Bélanger. And now the Coyotes changing. Upshaw's out. The teams are back to 5-on-5. Fired down to the Calgary zone. White there for it. Looks ahead for Stajan. And now the pistol for Morris. Stajan plays it in deep. The pistol blows a tire. In comes Stajan for the loose puck. Pass Stajan. Plays it there for Hagman. He was trying to find Freddie Meyer. Now they battle away for it. And reaching in is Bélanger, who plays it out, rolls all the way down to Kiprusoff. We'll watch that go wide. And that'll be icing against the Coyotes. 10:34 to play in the third period.
Best chance on that last Flames power play was shorthanded. Lauri Korpikoski takes the puck out of the air on the 2-on-1 and cues it wide of the net. And then here's this play by O'Coin. He reads that the shot is going to be short. He gets in front of Glenn Cross, denies the shot there. They clear it rather easily down the ice.
Stepniak fires it back down. That will not accomplish much, as once again, the Coyotes will be forced back into a faceoff and cannot change. And Dave Tippett may use his timeout here. Did it in the second period against Chicago the other night. Dave Tippett, a former Canadian Olympian, played for Dave King, now an assistant. Giordano shoots, kicked out by Brizgalov. Tippett with a great deal of respect for Dave King and was delighted to bring him onto his staff here in Phoenix.
King coached the Canadian Olympic team in 84 in Sarajevo. That's where Tippett played and was the captain of that team. He turned pro with the Hartford Whalers right after those Olympics.
Giordano up for Hagman. And back goes the pistol. Quick look, turn the puck over though to Hagman. Hagman and Moss, crisscrossing in the corner. Moss with it. Steps away from Turris. Works his way out in front. Loose puck. Knocked down. A chance in front for Hagman. Stopped by Brizgalov. The puck pinballing around and finally comes up to Upshaw, who flips it ahead. Bouwmeester being whacked there by Whitney. Sarich for Bouwmeester. Up for Bork. And now Glenn Cross gets to it. Centers it, and it's knocked down by Garrett Stafford. And Stafford on one knee can't clear it out. Here's Bork. Rene Bork works his way in front, gets a desperation shot away that goes wide. Now Bouwmeester back in front, off the side of the goal, hit a skate in front, and just missed. And now Jovanovski. Hard pass to Whitney. He'll backhand it down, and now Bouwmeester has to go back as Upshaw is bearing in on him. Sarich up ahead for Jokinen. And Ole Jokinen winds his way across the line. Deals back and plays it in deep. Calgary in the midst of a change. Glenn Cross feeds it in front. Brizgalov missed. And now the Coyotes break it out, but Pruka had it knocked away. As they battle forward at center ice. White. Up ahead to Jackman. Hansel works his way ahead, and Martin Hansel slowly picks his way ahead. The hulking Martin Hansel, 6'6", 230 pounds. And he can really motor.
Phoenix is defending this lead much like a prevent defense in football. I mean, man, they got to get the puck over the red line, or it's just a matter of time here. They've tested Kiprusoff very, very little in the last 15 minutes.
Here's Korpikoski trying to feed it in front. Picked out by Fittler. Back for Korpikoski. Centers it. Fiddler is shot. Kiprasov can't find it. They score! Fiddler with his second.
Well, there's just been nothing happening offensively for the Coyotes in the last 15 or 18 minutes. Nice cycle behind the net. Kiprasov can't find the puck. And the pass goes from Korpikoski to Fiddler. Fiddler beats Iginla to the loose puck. But Fiddler was open for a long enough period in the slot that Korpikoski's able to go behind the net, Gord, find him, make the pass, and Fiddler still has time to release the puck. That's their first two shots of the period. Fiddler's initial shot and then the rebound, and the Coyotes lead 4-2.
Steos battles there with Fiddler, and I'll buy it for it. So Vern Fiddler having a good night. And now Jokinen plays that to the line. Jerome Iginla is now -3 in the game tonight. And a coin swings back. Jovanovski plays that in front of the Calgary bench. And both teams will change. 6:45 to go in the third period. Calgary snapped a four-game losing streak with a win in Colorado the other night. Phoenix, meantime, is trying to win back-to-back games for the first time this year. Morrison back for Tanguay. Tanguay feeds it in front of Brzgalov. Got his right pad on that. Bouwmeester plays it back in deep for Tanguay. Back to Bouwmeester. Tipped in front by Meyer and cleared away by Yandel. Nifty tip in front. Now Tanguay plays it back in deep for Meyer. Saric across to Bouwmeester. Soft shot right in front, and Brzgalov will eat that up. 5:50 to go in the third. The NHL on TSN is back after this. Tonight's game story is brought to you by Molson Canadian, made from Canada. Vernon Fiddler's got his first two of the year. Rene Bourque's got his team-leading eighth, and Scotty Upshaw is fourth. Coyotes lead 4-2 with 5:50 to go in the third period. Now, Alex Tanguay spent a long stretch on the bench after getting his plus-minus to -3. Jerome Iginla is now -3. We'll see if he gets back on here in the last 5.5 minutes of the third period. Coin plays it across to Jovanovski, and no team was better at nursing leads than Phoenix was a year ago.
But Dave Tippett told us this morning one of the places they missed Zdeněk Mikulajčuk the most is when they had a lead and they had to defend it, because Mikulajčuk would play 23, 24 minutes a night, and he called them hard, heavy minutes.
Here's Jovanovski with a shot that misfired as Moss is in the way, and now Verbata sends it in deep. Now Mikulajčuk and Jovanovski played all the minutes against the other team's top lines. There's Jovanovski with a shot that goes wide. Now Hagman steps ahead with Moss. Hagman trying to feed that across. Prucha able to knock that down. Being harassed there by Backlund. And now the puck squirts free to Hagman, but he was poke checked. And Steo swings back. 4:45 to go in the third.
Here's again, look. Jackman and Stajan are his line mates.
So this essentially is two-thirds what began the game as the fourth line for Calgary. Flames began play today in 14th place in the Western Conference. Steos up ahead to Iginla. Shoots. It goes off the stick of Yandel. And out of play. 4:19 to go in the third. We're back right after this. It's race weekend here in Phoenix. Dale Earnhardt Jr. with his car on the ice in the first intermission. And we will have coverage of the Sprint Cup The Cobalt Tools 500 at 2 o'clock Eastern. That would be 11 a.m. Pacific, I would think, on Sunday. And please tell me that we're not going to be driving beside Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s car on the way out of the rink tonight, because I don't want to do that.
Well, if we are in your rental car, we're not going to catch him.
Oh, really?
That was a nice, comfy ride.
That big boat. Well, if you're going to trade pay to the highway with Dale Earnhardt Jr., you want some metal.
And there was a lot of it.
Rubbin's racing, as they say. Something like 150,000 people expected on the grounds for that race on Sunday. There's Tange with a Ginla and Stajan.
Now, this was supposed to be the Flames' first line at the beginning of the year when Stajan got hurt in the preseason.
Ginla stays out as Stajan goes off. And now Ginla shovels that in. Giordano steps up. Rink wide comes Moss, but Morris plays that away, and the puck heads down to the Flames zone. That'll be icing with 3:22 to go in the third. The NHL on TSN is brought to you by Molson Canadian, made from Canada.
Brent Sutter was just signaling to Mika Kiprusoff he wants him at 2.5 minutes. We're at 3:20, so let's look for Kiprusoff here in the next minute.
Backlund shot goes off a stick, up and out of play. It's been a difficult week for the Calgary Flames. In the early hours of Thursday morning, Brett Sutter, the son of Flames GM Daryl Sutter, and the nephew of Coach Brent, was arrested here in Phoenix, as you may have heard.
It's another old line, nothing good happens after 1 a.m.
Unless you're sleeping. Flames made aware of it and have offered no further comment. And there is the play offside at the Coyotes line. Daryl Sutter, the general manager, is on a scouting trip in the Czech Republic. And there is Brett Sutter, who had not played since October the 16th. Difficult situation all around. At the best of times, made more difficult by the deep connections involved.
You know, I guess so. I got a 22-year-old son, and at a certain point, they're responsible for themselves. I know because Daryl's the GM and Brent is the coach that it makes it a more entangled story, but at some point, the youngster's got to be responsible for his own actions, and dad can't be around all the time.
Brent Sutter doing a slow burn on the Calgary bench. Coyne steps up, so 2:40 to go. We'll keep our eye on Kiprusoff. Maybe Fiddler goes for the hat trick. And Kiprusoff edging his way towards the Calgary bench, now has to retreat. Here's Glenn Cross with it. And picks his way ahead as Kiprusoff makes his move and heads off. The extra skater's on. It's Hagman. Hagman sends that in front, knocked down by Yandel. And Fiddler is out there as Jokinen goes back. White fires that down in the Phoenix zone. And now Morris for Yandel, loose in front. Jokinen shot. Stop by Brzgalov. Loose puck. They whack away at it. And Brzgalov keeps the left pad down and is able to keep the puck out.
Derek Morris actually makes a nice play here. He's on his right side, but as the puck is rimmed around, he's got to play it with his skate. So he makes a good play, goes behind the net. Now Yandel goes to play it. It hits the back heel of his skate, and it pops directly out in front. Brzgalov gets a blocker and his throat protector on it. And then as the Flames whack away at it, Brzgalov's able to pin his left leg firmly to the ice.
All right, so what is the Razor's edge tonight?
Well, it's got to be Vern Fiddler. I mean, Vern Fiddler's had a terrific night for the Coyotes, not just for his offense, but he's good on the draw. He's created traffic. Shorthanded, he sets up Lori Korpikoski for a chance, and he gets his first of the season in the second period off his chest. And then this is a little bit more of a conventional one. High slot wrister, saved by Kiprusoff, and then he jumps on the rebound Vern Fiddler has created the edge for the Coyotes, and with two goals, he's on the ice for a defensive zone faceoff under 2 minutes left.
And with the Calgary net empty, a golden opportunity for Vern Fiddler to get his first career NHL hat trick. Not bad for a guy who came into this game having not scored in his last 21. He knows how to bust a slump, huh?
If he picks up another one right here, it's all of a sudden the average goes up in a hurry.
1:45 to go. White up ahead for Iginla. And now Fiddler gains center ice, shoots, scores! Hat trick, Vern Fiddler! Third Coyote to have a hat trick this year.
A lot of smiles on the Coyotes bench. Fiddler is a glue player. Does a lot of the dirty work. When he came over from Nashville, they found that he was a more complete player than they thought. Plays in all situations for the Coyotes. One of those unheralded guys that is rewarded with an empty net goal and his first NHL hat trick.
And the Edmonton native does it against Calgary. And look at the smiles on the faces of the Coyotes players enjoying their teammate's success. That goal into the empty net may have traveled further than all the other goals that he scored in his career combined.
You know, when you shoot at the empty net in practice, man, you can hit that thing 100 times out of 100. You do it in a game, and it looks pretty small down there. And he bounced it in there, kind of hopped its way along. 5 shots on goal for Fiddler tonight. The hat trick with 98 seconds left, and the Coyotes will win back-to-back games for the first time this season.
And they'll send the Flames to their 4th loss in their last 5. And I'm assuming someone got the puck. Stajan plays that ahead for Tanguay. Korpikoski, by the way, with 3 assists tonight. And a point draws a helper as well. This is going to be a long flight for the Flames into San Jose. And that long bus trip from Oakland down to San Jose is going to feel even longer.
And not an easy place to play in San Jose.
Stefan Meyer. Kiprasov is back in the Calgary goals. We're to the final minute now of the 3rd period. Centering pass, and Tanguay scores. Alex Tanguay with the tap-in. And it's a 5-3 game.
Nice pass by Stajan, and Tanguay goes to the net. This looks like one team that played an extra shift in the game and another that just fell asleep. Stajan walks out. Kyle Turris has got his back turned to the player. He's responsible for Tanguay, but he's staring at the puck. The pass goes right through the goal crease, and Tanguay has an easy one. It's 5-3.
Across to Jackman, out for Morrison. Brinkwine, he goes for Giordano in the final 30 seconds now of the 3rd. Giordano with a shot, and Brizgalov hangs on to that.
Brent Sutter almost certainly is thinking about where this went wrong and thinking about tomorrow, what has to happen, because you can't change so much about what you have left here with 26 and a half seconds left. But you run out of line combinations, you run out of ways to juggle the lineup. Your players just have to be able to play better if you're going to win for a more consistent period of time.
Steyo centers it, they score! Jackman!
Not so fast.
Yes, 19 and a half seconds to go. And suddenly, it's a 1-goal game again.
Again, the Coyotes get caught chasing the puck. Staios makes a nice move down the wall. And his pass to Jackman is a good one. Brent Sutter's talked about how much he's liked Jackman throughout this season. He skates, he gets chances on goal. Here he finishes in just under 20 seconds. All of a sudden, it's a one-goal game.
Second of the year for Jackman. Kiprusoff is halfway between the Flames' goal and the blue line, but the Coyotes control off the faceoff. That was a big win by Fiddler. And in comes Korpikoski. Backhand shot stopped by Kiprusoff. Back in front, the pass misses Kyatt. Final seconds, one more rush for the Flames. Bork, long drive, Brzgalov handles it. We'll get a faceoff in the Coyotes' zone with 1.3 seconds remaining in the third period.
Korpikoski throws the puck out in front of the net from behind the Calgary net. It looked a lot like the way Nashville lost against the Blackhawks last year in the playoffs. There's really no reason for Korpikoski to throw it out. Dave Tippett's yelling at the official, let's go, let's go. Either make them call a timeout or drop the puck. So the Flames here for the last 35 seconds have in essence been able to set up a play.
And continue to do so as Tippett's wondering why the puck isn't being dropped.
I guess they're checking the clock to make sure. 1.3 seconds left.
Jokinen on the faceoff against Fiddler.
He'll try and draw it to Bork.
And everyone moved. And the discussion continues. They're going to show Jokinen out. And in will come Glenn Cross against Fiddler. Takes a whack at it, and Bork can't pull the trigger. So the Coyotes win it 5-4 despite a couple of late goals from the Flames. Vern Fiddler gets his first career National Hockey League hat trick. And the Flames' struggles continue in what will be a very tough month of November. For Ray Ferraro and all of us at TSN, I'm Gord Miller. Thanks for tuning in. This is a presentation of TSN, Canada's sports leader.